श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा श्री कृष्णा। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णु गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः, गुरु साक्षात् परम ब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः, तस्मै श्री गुरवे नमः। वी आर स्टडीइंग त्रिपुरा रहस्य। Pura means a city, a town. Tri means three. So, the tale of three cities. There was a book, Tale of Two Cities, Tale of Three Cities. And in these three cities, there is one goddess who is living. So that is Tripura Devi. And Rahasya, the secret of this Tripura Devi. Normally, when we look at our life, we take into account only one part of our life. Out of the four, we take only one. We take into account either the waking or the dream or the deep sleep or the samadhi. But the substratum which is supporting all the four, we conveniently neglect or overlook. And therefore, we keep on struggling throughout our life. So to tell this text, a dialogue between Bhagwan Dattatreya and the disciple Parashuramji Maharaj, brings out this theme. That this knowledge can be had from someone who is established in this knowledge. And then we come to know that this knowledge doesn't seclude us from the world. It is not like going into Jada Samadhi. It is not like having many powers to bless somebody or to curse somebody. It is not that we are some extraordinary because of this. All these extra factors are discarded and we come to discover the substratum which supports all the specialities. It is for this purpose we are studying this Tripura Rahasya. And in the development of the story, we came across this girl or the lady called as Hemalekha and her husband as Hemachud. And here in the sixth chapter, we have seen that if we want to know this knowledge, Shraddhavan Labhate Jnanam Tatparaha Sayyate Indriyaha, we have to begin on the foundation of Shraddha. Shraddha is Shastrasya Guru Vakyasya Satya Buddhyavadharana Sa Shraddha Kathita Sadbhihi Yaya Vastu Upalabhyate. Shraddha is that because of which we are able to cognize the reality. And how we manifest this Shraddha, whatever is said in our scriptures and whatever is taught to us by the teacher who is Shrotriya Brahmanishta, how that is right. This positive approach to the understanding of the scriptures in the light of logic and our experience put together is called a Shraddha. Up to here we have seen. Now after this is done, we now enter the seventh chapter. So towards the end of the sixth chapter, the student Hemachud asked a question. He said, Yadyasya bhimatam tat sa vadatti vasunishchitam anyashchapya vasitam Hani pradam api priye. There are so many varieties of philosophies. There are so many gods. Some of them they say Krishna is the highest. Some of them say Rama is the highest. Some of them say the Shiva is the highest. Some of them say Dattatreya is the highest. In this manner, there are so many philosophies, and each one of them claim this is the ultimate. All others are rubbish. See. Like about Bhagavad Gita, the teachers glorify ki He who has studied Bhagavad Gita, ya swayam padmanabhasya mukapadmad vinisrita, that which has come directly from the mouth of Bhagavan Krishna, after having studied this kimannai shastraihi, there is no need of studying any scriptures. Those who are studying Ramayana, they say, forget about everything. Even Lord Shiva says, Rama Rameti Rameti Rame Rame Manorame Sahasra Nama Tatulyam Rama Nama Varanane. So you don't have to waste your time in chanting 1000 names of Shiva, Lord Vishnu. In this manner, there are so many different approaches. Tatraiva Sati Naivantam Kaschid Atrapi Gacchati. And therefore, why me, most of the people are unable to come to a final conclusion. Tatraiva sati na eva antam kaschid atrapi gacchati yaha shunyamaha tatvam saha api ashunyam dushayet param. So those who are calling the reality as a shunya, absolute absence, they are condemned by the other one. Those who say, no, there is no possibility of absence existing. Because unless the absence exists, it cannot be proved. Therefore, the shunya or absence is not the reality. In this manner, ashradheyam kuto vata sangatam chagame nahi etat bruhi priye samyak nahi etat asti achintatam. Therefore, kindly tell me, everybody is talking with this, you know, quoting the scriptures, and they quote the scripture so perfectly well. Therefore, we get confused. And I am sure you must have thought over this thing. Therefore, kindly explain me properly. What is the truth? How to proceed? See? This is how many sampradayas are formed. Once I was going some place to PremPuri Yatra. And on my way, it was very hot sun. So we stopped someplace, and there was one, Mama, come ahead, there is place for you. Call her ahead. So, we stopped on a roadside near some field, and in that field, we had some water and all that. So I asked the local people, host, are you not coming to Pandharpur? No, we don't go to Pandharpur. We are the followers of Datta Sampradaya. Digambara, Digambara, Sripada Vallava Digambara. See? Jai Jai Panduranga Hari, Jai Jai Vittala Hari. No. Digambara, Digambara. Everybody is lost only in their brand value. Therefore, O teacher, my dear wife, kindly tell me what is the truth. Now, this is not anybody else's question, it is our question. See? When it is Monday, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya. When it is Tuesday, Sri Guru Charana Sarovar Jaraja. So every day is a different brand. And we get so lost and confused. So kindly tell me, what is the truth? Iti Prushta, now enter the 7th chapter. Iti Prushta Hemalekha Bhartra Priyatarenasa Provacha Vidushi Samyak Vidnyata Loka Samstitihi Shrunuvakshe Priyatama Sthirashanta Samadaran Manohi Markata Prayam Astiram Sarvadayvatan Eyata Evam Mahanartha Praptavan Prakrutojanaha Chanchalan Manaha Sarvadukha Nidhanam Drushtamevahi Yataha Sushuptau Chalana bhavad vindanti vai sukham tasman mana sthiri krutya shrunu yate bravimiham. Now she says, she was very happy when her husband asked this question, and she knew this is the problem with everyone in this world. See, when we understand this basic principle, problems are not only for one particular person. Problems are for everyone. For example, fight between husband and wife. Every husband and every wife, they have to fight. Otherwise, they cannot be husband and wife. See, God has made them in this particular format. This is the way. Similarly, the children and the parents. The children are meant to defy the parents. Never listen to them. So those who don't have children, they are miserable. Those who have children, they are super miserable. There is no end to it. Therefore, she knew that this is vidnyata loka samstitihi. The mind is very disturbed. What should we do? Because most of the teachers listen only one problem from everyone. And that is complaining about the mind. Stop complaining. Start analyzing. And start learning from the reactions of your own mind. Then a seeker is born. See, friends. Therefore, she said, Shrunu vakshe priyatama sthira shanta samadharan manohi markata prayam astiram sarvadaivatat. Oh, my dear husband, kindly listen with all respect and reverence and how sthira shantaha. Remain steady, be careful, be attentive. When this is said, it is not that you are not attentive. But importance of a steady mind, not a sleepy mind. Most of the time our mind is reacting. Instead of absorbing, it is reacting like the urticaria. Therefore, she says, Manohi markata praya mastiram sarva daivatat. So don't be surprised. Mind is like that, like a monkey. See, can you imagine, there is one shloka which tells this condition. A monkey having taken a lot of liquor and thereafter he was stung by a scorpion. And then with that monkey, you want to go and control that monkey. What will be the condition? Worse than that is the condition of our mind. See, Arjuna also says, Chanchalam hi mana krishna pramathi balavadrudham etasyaham nigraham manne vayu reva sudushkaram. The mind is having four things. Chanchalam hi mana krishna pramathi balavadrudham. Four. Chanchalam, absolutely unsteady. Pramathi, not only itself remains disturbed, but disturbs everyone around. All the sense organs are disturbed because of the mind. Then balavad, and it is so powerful that you want to control the mind, but the mind cannot be controlled. And drudha. Drudha is obstinate. Jiddi. See? And all these four things are reflected in our character. See? And this is what we experience every day. You tell people, they come, please sit down. No, no, we sit on the floor. No, sit, there is a chair. Don't sit on the floor. I feel very uncomfortable. No, you may feel, but I also feel uncomfortable. I will sit. Then you make a hole and go down. Useless. This is the biggest problem. Small little things you don't listen, and then you will listen. You are Brahman. No, I am not Brahman. I am be a group. Continue. See, friends. Drudham. This is biggest obstacle. This is called Duragraha. Duragraha is the one because of which we are unable to discard the body identification. When it is very clearly established, accepted logically, then all the problems begin because of the body identification. No, that is all true, but you know, we have to live in this world. Meaning what? Body identification is essential, and thereafter all problems are essential. Then how to solve the problems? See? Then go to a liquor or a shop and drink and be spiritual. See, friend, this is not the way. Pramathi balavad drudham. So, markada priya asthiram sarvadaivahi tat. Yataha eva mahanartham praptavan prakrito janaha. It is because of this prakrito janaha, means the uncultured people. Prakrita. Prakrita means in our modern language, villagers. But actually villagers are more cultured than the city folks. So prakritam janaha. Maha anartham praptavan. They are suffering only because of this. Chalan manaha sarva dukkha nidanam drushtamevahi. So this unsteady, constantly changing mind is the cause of all the miseries of our life. first step. With a disturbed mind, you cannot listen. When the mind is disturbed, we react. See? Like you are told, be happy, don't be miserable. A person who is miserable because of something, he will react. Don't be miserable. Get married and then show. When your wife will torture you, then you will understand. So that person is not listening. He is reacting. See, friends. Therefore, here the teacher says, Chalan manaha sarva dukkha nidanam drushtamevahi. It is very clearly seen in the whole world. This unsteady, disturbed mind is the cause of all miseries. Bhagavad Gita says, Ashantasya kutas sukham. A person who is not at peace with himself, he can never experience bliss. Now, to make us understand, she gives an example. Yataha sushuptau chalana abhavad vindanti vai sukham tasmad manaha sthiri krutya shrunu yatte bravimi aham. Because sushuptau in the deep sleep, chalana abhavad, the mind is absolutely free from movement. Be very attentive. Wherever there is a sequence established, we are in the mind. Let there be no sequence, mind is dissolved. Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram, Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Only the mind. Because sequence is established. Now no sequence. Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Where is the mind? Mind is nothing but the binary language of the computer science. In the binary language, only two components, zero and one. Chinese, that yin yang, zero and one. If we take that one, which is not followed by two, we merge in the absolute. See, friends, the sequence should be arrested. So, chalana abhavat vindati vayat sukham, and therefore in the deep sleep, entering the deep sleep begins, event number one. Thereafter, no event. Then the second event is, deep sleep is over. Then we try to establish how much time. See, friends, wherever sequence is established, mind is born. That is the reason why absence is to be taken as an object of contemplation. Absence of sounds. Sounds are many, changing, varying, different types, but silence is one. So make silence as the object of knowledge. In this, mind dissolves. With such a mind, when we listen, then the understanding takes place. Recently, I was in Arunachal Pradesh, and there the children are so unique. Any language, Malayali, Tamil, Gujarati, Bengali, Assamese, Marathi, Punjabi, any language. You teach them bhajans or songs in one or two goes. They by heart did 100%. Any language. You tell them once, they understand clearly. The reason is, mind is absolutely steady. See, with such a mind alone, when we listen, it is no more an information that is collected, but it is a knowledge that happens. Therefore, she tells that tasman manaha sthiri krutya shrunu yate bravimyaham. So whatever I am going to tell you, first of all, steady your mind. Don't keep on running here and there. See, friends. That is why when we sit for listening, remain as nobody. Don't become anybody. Mother, father, brother, sister, husband, wife, guru, shishya, friend, enemy, good, bad, lucky, unlucky. All these dumb things, drop them once for all. And then you see how it is easier. So, anadarena shrutaschar bhaved shrutam asam shruta sammatim afalam syat atyantam yatha achitra tarushraya. And if somebody is listening without reverence and commitment, anadarena shrutancha bhaved ashruta sammitam, it is as good as not listening. Because whenever we are listening without respect and reverence, we will not absorb it. Now take your own experiences in life. Whenever in our school days or so, we did not like any particular teacher, we don't want to learn that subject. See? Sanskrit, for example. I never used to like that teacher. Never learned Sanskrit in my life. Useless language. No Sanskrit. Because your teacher you don't like. So unless we have this ardor for the subject matter, then only we can listen. Anadarena shrutanchet bhavet ashrut sammitam afalam syat atyantam. And therefore such a listening without proper quality of the mind is yielding no results. And such people become professional satsangi. See, friends, this is one of the biggest things, please observe. Suppose I claim to be a student of Vedanta. Suppose I claim to be the student of Bhagavad Gita. And all the time, miserable, frustrated, depressed, dejected, such people bring bad name to that Bhagavad Gita. We know Bhagavad Gita, what kind of people these are. If you have studied Gita, you have lost right to be miserable. Studying Bhagavad Gita and remaining miserable, you are bringing bad name to that. See? Like there are many people who call their guru as Bhagavan. And you see their behavior, so disgusting. They bring a bad name to their guru. Guru is not bad. They say, we know the who his follower he is. All are like that. They talk ill about each other. They don't have courtesy. They don't talk properly. They complain about each other. That means their guru has taught you or what? No. We are only collecting the information and not practicing in life. So, apalam syat atyantam yatha chatra tarushrayaha. Just like when you look at the picture of a mango tree, from the mango tree picture, you don't get the fruits. You can look only at them. You don't get it. In the same manner, on the walls, you will see many places it is written, serve all, love all. It makes no difference to the wall. So also the people who write, they are stones. They are more concerned about the discipline. They are not concerned about the love, sacrifice, understanding, service. See, friends. Therefore, anavastita tarkatvam apahaya vinashanam sattarkamashritya janaha prapnuya sufalam drutam. in a similar manner. So first of all, not listening with the proper mind. Second thing, anavasthita tarkatvam apahaya vinashanam. Many times we get lost into a kutarka, the long wrong logic. In the last story we have seen the Shunga who came and he gave such a logic that the students of that great teacher, they all became atheists and they destroyed themselves. Therefore, Narada Bhakti Sutra very clearly tells, Vado na avalambyaha. This principle I have been following sincerely throughout my life because I learned from this principle. Initially, I used to talk to people, discuss or explain them, question answer. But after some time I found it's all rubbish. Then the new principle was discovered. I'll talk to you on condition number one. No discussion. Two, no argument. Over. Vado na avalambya. See, there are people who are argumentative. One word you say, 100 words they will say. See, friends. Therefore, sattarkam ashritya janaha prapnuyat sufalam drutam. Unless there is sattarka. Sattarka means what? Logic falling in line with the scriptures. See, for example, scriptures tell, you have not created the body, you are not able to control your body, and there is no reason what can justify that you are body. See? No, that is all true, but then gone. The moment the butting begins, you are out. But then, you know, we have to live in this world, we have to take care of our parents or children, but is it not? Then don't cry, Baba, do whatever you like. Don't ask me anything. See, friends. Therefore, sattarkam ashritya janaha. So if we have to practice this, that I cannot be the body, then what should be the practice? The practice should be, follow the symptoms and come to discover the cause. Imagine, suppose I am not identified with the body as in deep sleep. That time, what is the experience? Number one, our existence is independent of the body. Number two, when we are not identified with the body, we are nobody. All relations, mother, father, brother, sister, husband, wife, gone. Then number three, there are no possessions and yet we continue to exist. Number four, there is no sense of otherness. Number five, there is no desire. Number six, we are all happy for no reason. These are the symptoms when we are not identified with the body as in deep sleep. Yes. Now what should be the spiritual practice now? These symptoms must be manifested in our life while we are awake. And this is what Bhagavan Krishna says, Ya nisha sarva bhutanam tasyam jagrati sayyami yasyam jagrati bhutani sa nisha pashato munehe. This is the meaning. So if we are practicing this to be free from the body identification, what should happen is the burden of possessions and relations should be mercilessly dropped. See, friends. No, but Swamiji, is it not our responsibility? Baba, don't cry, suffer with the tabla peti. Dekho Maharaj, Nayamatma balahine na labhyaha. Don't be a weakling in life. So, sattarkam ashritya janaha prapnya supalam drutam. Sattarka samshrayenashu sadhanaika parobhaved sattarka janita shaddam prapya iha phalabhang naraha. Therefore, one should take refuge in the proper logic, falling in line with the scriptures. Such a person, sadhanaika parojanaha, the one who is thus following the spiritual practice, sattarka janita shraddham prapya, then alone his Shraddha, his faith will be falling in line with the scriptural authority and Phalabhag Naraha. Then alone he will be able to experience what is mentioned in the scriptures, that asangoham, asangoham, asangoham punapunaha, satchidananda rupoham, ahameva hamavyaha. These words become our experience. These are no more words. When the words become experience, then it is meaningful. When the words carry no experience, no meaning, it is only a noise. Therefore, anavasthita tarkantam vihaya lokaya priya pravrutti vetam jagataha shraddaya phalashalinim. Therefore, kindly give up this wrong kind of logic and come to know jagataha etam pravrutti shraddaya phalashalinim. The whole world is conducting the business of life only on the foundation of the Shraddha, which is falling in line with the scriptures. See, the whole life. Example she gives. Sutarkitena kalena karkashaha kshvam vikarshati shraddhaya eva tatha rupya svarna ratna shadhasha adhikam aushadha adhikam. Sutarkikena kalena, the karkasha, the farmers, they have seen it. In this particular time when you sow, plow, make the ground properly, then the crop comes properly. Shraddha only. Last year there were no rains, the whole crop has gone to dogs. Therefore, this year I don't think I will do it. No, every year they do. What is the foundation? Is only the Shraddha. See, friends, therefore, here the teacher says, don't get lost only in this logic, because this is gold, this is diamond, it is only Shraddha. Once I went to see one diamond exhibition in a very big hall, and the moment you enter, there is a big board. Put your hands folded like Vivekananda. Move around, don't unfold your hands. If you touch anything, the gun will shoot you on the spot. So people move inside. They are not looking at the diamonds. And when we crossed that hall and all that, then that, you know, rule was out. Then that person said, yes, you have got any question? I said, no, you will shoot me. He said, no, it is limited to that hall. I said, okay. He said, do you want to touch? I said, yes. So he showed me one diamond, I touched it. I said, what is great about it? Why you people are so mad after the diamonds? To be very frank, nobody asked me this question. And I also don't know why I am mad after the diamonds. What is the logic? There is no logic. Therefore, it is said here, vyavasanti sutarkena tyaktva tarkanavastitim tasmat sutarka shraddhaya vyavasya shreya atmanaha. Therefore, one should take refuge in the proper shraddha in line with the scripture, then only we can do good to ourselves. Prajateta sadhanaya nahi tarkanavastitehe vyurameta paurushirajajnan shrunganugara no nara iva. Therefore, one should follow the path of proper logic as per the scriptures. Otherwise, if you simply take refuge in the logic is never conclusive. Any logic you take, it cannot be conclusive. Your logic is only a relative standpoint. And God has given us intellect in such a manner that we can put logic for everything in our favor. Anything can be proved. Therefore, do not take this logic, otherwise we will be destroying ourselves. It is something like that. Wrong logic. Yato vacho nivartante aprapya manasasaha, Upanishad says, the truth is that where from the speech and the mind return without comprehending it. Therefore, don't think about God, don't chant God's name. By chanting God's name, God will not hear. Why? He doesn't have ears, he doesn't have nose, he doesn't have eyes, he doesn't have tongue, he doesn't have mind. Then what is to be done? Soja. See, this is the wrong logic. Therefore, Shraddhaya Paurushoparaha na vihandanti sarvatha, Drudham Paurusham ashrityana prapte the katham phalam. Therefore, the one who is putting efforts properly in line with the scriptural authority and the full faith in that, such a person can never, never be unsuccessful in life. Therefore, Drudham Paurusham ashritya, one should be firmly committed to the efforts, and with the proper efforts put in the right direction, one shall na katham prapyeta phalam. Why will he not attain success in life? As much efforts we put forward in living in this relative world, if that much efforts we put forward to get out of this relative world, it is enough. What is the reason? We are not able to do this. Only one reason. We have not discovered the value of it. See, unless we discover the value for this, we will not be able to achieve anything in life. See, first, we all have recognized the value of money. Therefore, there are no efforts lacking on our part for earning money. We have learned. Similarly, if we have learned the value of mind at peace, then we'll take care of the mind. We have hardly taken care of our mind. Mind is going and growing wild day by day. The wilderness of the mind is obsession. Not listening. Not changing. One has to recognize this. We have to change in life. Readiness to change and ability to change. So, Drudham Paurusham Ashrityam Na Prapyet Katham Phalam Paurushat Karshaka Dhanam Vanijo Dhanamevacha Raja Lakshim Nrupa Vipra Vidyam Sarva Sukashrayam. It is only by the proper efforts that the farmers yield harvest, the traders earn money, the kings have the lot of wealth, and the wise people attain scriptural knowledge. It is only by efforts. See? For us it is known, it is very difficult, like about the mind. No, Swami is okay, but it is very difficult to control the mind. Tell us some shortcut. See? So shortcut is this. Stop doing everything. See? It's two things which I told you so many times. Work on it sincerely. It will change the whole life. Simultaneously. One, stop talking to yourself. Two, before talking to others, ask a question. Is it necessary to talk? Do it simultaneously. When you stop talking to yourself, you are controlled karmendriya. When you start listening to silence, you are controlled jnanendriya. Jnanendriyas receive the things. Karmendriyas react to the things. Jnanendriya tells, this is a beautiful flower. Karmendriya walks, plucks the flower, puts on the head, and becomes a mobile flower pot. There's two things. Nanendriyas and Karmendriyas, if they are controlled, mind dissolves. This is the technique. You don't have to do anything else. So, Shrudram, Hruti, Sudham, Deva, Tapasa, Lokam, Uttamam, Prapuranne, Api, Abhimatam, Paurusheena, Eva, Karmana. Similarly, all the people, such as the ignorant people, they are earning their bread and butter, the gods earning their amrutam, the tapasvis are attaining the higher worlds. Therefore, by proper efforts, one can attain anything in life. Therefore, don't give up. This is the meaning. Don't give up. Only thing, we must follow this clear picture. What is the goal? What is the destination that we have to achieve in life? Then you'll come to know there's only one destination. We are at peace with ourselves. Under all conditions. That is the goal of life. Nothing and nobody in this world should have freedom to disturb our poise. And when you feel that these are the sources of disturbances, run away. Don't feel bad if you have to run away. Run away. Bhagavan Krishna ran away. Run chod. Every time you don't have to fight. Run away. Importance is peace of our mind. That is important. That is the crux of all spiritual practice. Bhagavan says, Nasti buddhi ayuktasya. He who doesn't have this yukti, this knack, he cannot have the proper understanding. Nasti ayuktasya bhavana. He cannot practice being the divine. See? Nacha bhavaita shanti. If you don't practice that you are divine, you cannot be at peace. And ashantasya kuta sukham, a person who is disturbed, how can ever be happy? If you remember, I told you many years before, I was with Swami Akhandanji Maharaj, and when I saw him in a most chaotic condition, he was absolutely at peace. Nobody has ever seen him disturbed, angry, shouting at anybody, not even once in his lifetime. It is possible. One example I'll tell you, when such a mind is normally existing, what is the quality of thinking? When he was very old, not able to see because of the cataract operation, so there used to be some people serving him, some swamis. So when he was going, people always want to do namaskar to a walking Mahatma so that he falls down. That is the only purpose. Any number of times you tell, keep away, they don't listen. When they don't listen, this simple thing, don't do namaskar. Do you think they listen, you are Brahman? Nahi, nahi, mai karunga namaskar. You are Brahman? Nahi, nahi, mai Brahman nahi. Suffer. So one old man, and old is particular, they never listen. So one old man, yet although having told, don't do namaskar, he did. So one of the swami, he pushed him, don't do, I am telling you. And the old man fell down. When this happened, Swamiji was absolutely at peace. He didn't say one word. And he went to his room with the same swami who was helping him. He said, Subhudananji Maharaj, please come. Sit down. Let us think. He said, when that man, old man, he was doing me namaskar and you told him not to do because it is hurting me, out of good intentions you told him, but he doesn't listen. And then you pushed him and he fell down. Now from this event, let us learn. Whether you pushed him away because he was doing namaskar and it is hurting me, or you pushed him because although you told him don't do namaskar and he did not listen to you and therefore you pushed him, think. What could have been the reason? When I am telling you don't do that. See friends, ashantasya kutas sukham. How many times we are told so many things. He is just stone-like. We don't want to change ourselves. That is why after having gone to satsang so many places, so many years, you see the professional satsangis are more detrimental than the average people. Okay, Shrudra Bhrutim Sudhadeva Tapasa Lokamuttavam Prapuhu Anne Api Abhimatam Paurushenaiva Karmana Anavastita Tarkena Ashraddhena Purushenakim Kada Kanchit Katham Prapta Palam Vada Vimrushata. Therefore, you just think, Vimrusha, properly inquire and find out those who have done the only dry logic, shushka tarka, and those who were without any faith and devotion and without proper efforts, can such a person ever attain any fulfillment in his life? And if you say, kvachit phala visamvada sarvatra ashvasa varjane vijaniyad daivahatam tam swatma ripu rupinam. And if you imagine, suppose something you get, out of just a logic or, you know, some kakataliyana, then such a person will be always the enemy number one to himself. Don't go into this kind of things. You know, I don't know. By God's grace it happened. Nothing happens by God's grace. You have to put efforts. See, friends, many people are very much enchanted by some kind of magic, some kind of chamatkar happening. These chamatkaric people, they will never be successful in life. All the time depending on chamatkar, you know. See, we have come across so many people. They have been very close to the great masters. And yet you see the quality of their life, totally disgusting. Nobody wants them around. See? And their whole personal life is in a mess, the whole family is in a mess. What is the use of such a proximity with the Mahatma? Like Dhruva, he had the vision of God, and what he has achieved? Nothing. In the same manner, simply attending satsanga, going to Mahatmas, going to temple, without bringing any change in oneself, is all absolutely wrong. Therefore, one should not all the time imagine, no, I am unfortunate, I am not getting it. There is nothing like daiva, there is nothing like unfortunate. Put efforts properly. See? One girl told me, Swamiji, you always tell, you know, do your best. I did my best, but I failed. I said, your best should match with the required best. My best is I can't write anything. That is my best. That is not the meaning. We should be able to achieve what is required. That is called as your best. So, Swatma Ripu Rupinam Ataha Paurushumacharitya Shraddha Sattarka Poshitam Shreisam Yan Mukhyatamam Sadhanam Tasamashrahed. Therefore, proper Purushartha, proper efforts with proper faith, and taking the support of the logic, supported by the scriptural authority, these three things put together is the means of attainment of fulfillment in life. See how beautiful it is. Tatra drushta sadhana nam vaititrancha prathagvidam teshu yat sarvatam sarvata sadhyam sadhe tadhi mukhyakam. And now the teacher says, there may be many differences appearing in the various kinds of spiritual practices. The important teshu yas sarvatha sadhyam sadhayet tadhi. Don't bother what others are doing. See, friends, spiritual practice is not a mimicry. Like, you know, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, he was a great logician. He was an erudite pandit, extremely intelligent, devoted. And on the banks of Ganges in Varanasi, then when he came across one great devotee and his logic was dissolved before his devotion, and he dropped everything and became a great devotee of the Lord and became so intoxicated that he was not aware of his clothes. And he was in that madness, dancing like that. Therefore, if others are dancing, that doesn't mean they will realize. See, friends, spiritual practice is not a mimicry. But most of the people think it is a mimicry. See? Therefore, somebody sitting in a particular posture, you acha hum bhi baithe. Somebody is having Rudrakshamala. Okay, let's Rudrakshamala. No, but somebody is having Tulasimala. Tulasimala. The third person is having a Spatikamala. Now he gets confused. Kya karu? Then he discovers a new technique. Let me have a hybrid mala. One bead Rudraksha, one Tulasi, one Spatika. And then he puts on. One person asked me this question in Nepal. Therefore, I am telling you. Swamiji, what is the purpose of this kind of mala? I said, this mala is, this spatika gives you Lakshmi. And this tulasi gives you devotion.
Oh, very good.
And Rudraksha deletes both. So what to do? I said, you remain equipoise. Friends, don't get carried away. This is not spirituality. Therefore, teshu yat sarvatha sadhyam, whatever is natural inclination for you. See? Somebody doing yoga, so you start doing yoga. Somebody doing shirshasana, don't do that. Just find out where you are naturally inclined. See? Many times it happens, you know, others are doing meditation. And then discuss. तुम कितना meditation करते हो? हो जाता है तीन चार घंटे. Okay, I'll show you. And this fellow start doing meditation 3-4 hours. And after few days he becomes mad. What happened? Meditation में ऐसे हो. Don't get carried away by relax. These few fundamentals I am telling you, please hold on to that. Number one, when you can live at a zero desire level, you are one with God. Number two, when you have no questions, you are free from mind. See, you don't have to do anything. No questions. Why? Because the sky is so high. No question. No, but people say you should do chant Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. And then they say, you know, first you should say Hare Ram, Hare Ram, or Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna. One person wrote me one email or WhatsApp. Swamiji, Bhishmacharya left his body on Bhishmashtami. And he gave Vishnu Sahasranam Upadesh to Yudhishthir on Ekadashi, Vaikuntha Ekadashi. How this is possible? I wrote, ask Bhishmacharya. Don't ask me. How does it matter who said what? You remain at peace with yourself. See, friends, don't Imagine spiritual life is information collection. Delete all that is possible. There is nothing worth knowing in this world. Therefore, teshu tat sarvatha sadhyam sadhaye taddhi mukhyakam. So whichever is convenient for your natural inclination, that you follow. If your natural inclination is chanting the Lord's name, take the mala comfortably. Om Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. Om Sri Ram, Jai Ram, Jai Jai Ram. And when you are chanting this, only find out what is the impact of this chanting on the mind. Is the mind at peace or not? Are we struggling to finish the number? Are we finishing it as a burden? We have chanted so many years together. Have we discovered fulfillment in life? Do some experiments. Suppose you are chanting or sitting for meditation on a particular time, particular place. One day don't do it purposely. Today I'm not going to do meditation. Then watch your mind. Suppose you are observing fast, Ekadashi. Ekadashi, take food, watch your mind. Then slowly we learn how to work on the mind. We have to work on the mind. Instead of working on the mind is working on us. Therefore, Teshu yas sarvatha sadhyam, whatever is easily practicable for you, do that. Tat sutarkanu bhutibhyam vyavasyashu shubharaved, tatte sarvam pravakshami savadana shunushvatan. Therefore, tat sutarka anubhutibhyam vyavasyashu samarved. So whatever is conveniently and natural inclination you have, that should be practiced. Sutarka anubhutibhyam. Be attentive. Three things. Number one, the source of wisdom is scriptures or guru. Number two, it should be logically accepted by us. First accept, and then through logic confirm. Logic is applied for confirmation of what is heard. And the third thing is the anubhuti. Analyze your experience in the light of this knowledge and conviction. Is it true or not? Find out. Like this example we give you, that our existence is independent of body. This is the statement of truth. Scriptures tell. Before this body was born, we existed. After this body dies, we continue to exist. Therefore, the existence that we are independent of this body. Now, is it possible? So, first you accept. Then second thing, logic. Yes, in the last life, this body was not there, but I have done a good mischief, so I must be there. Next life also, this body will not be there, but I will be suffering or enjoying, so I must be there also. The body doesn't go through the karma phala. It is the embodied who goes through the karma phala experiences. Therefore, logically accepted, yes. I existed before, now and thereafter. Very good. Now, anubhuti, experience. In the dream, we are not identified with the body yet. We experience dream. So our dream is experience independent of the gross body identification. Our deep sleep is experience independent of the gross body and subtle body existence. So, Shruti, Yukti and Anubhuti. Authority of the scriptures, logic and the experience, Anubhuti. So, Tat Sutarka Anubhuti Bhyam Vivasyashu Samarabhed. Now practice in this manner your spiritual practice. Whatever you are doing. Suppose you are doing pranayam. Very good. Do pranayam. And then you will come to know that when the pranayam is practiced during that period, the mind is relatively quiet. And the relative quietness of the mind remains as a momentum of quietness which is gathered in the mind as a result of pranayama. But like the moment of the fan, movement stops after some time, although the switch is off. In the same manner, this momentum of quietness of the mind disappears after the impact of the pranayama is over. Find out. Therefore, pranayama cannot give you the ultimate peace. It is something like when you are ironing the clothes, the wrinkles are very hard. So we sprinkle little water just to soften the wrinkles. In the same manner, pranayama is like sprinkling water on the wrinkles of thoughts in the mind. By that, the wrinkles become softened. And then, eka chintanat. Now that mind which has become a little soft, now employ for the inquiry about the one. In this manner, sutarkana bhutibhyam vivasyashu sabharabet tatte sarvam pravakshani samarvakshami savadhana shunu shvatat. Shreyaha taddhivijaniyad yasmat bhuyona shochati shokaha sarvata evasya drushati sukshmayadrusha. Now, what is the ultimate? What is the shreyas? What is the ultimate attainment in one's life? See. Shreyaha tadhi vijaniyad yasmad bhujo na shochati. Shreyas, the ultimate good in our life is there are no leftover regrets or arrogance of success in life. No shok. I should have done that. I should not have done that. Both are completely gone. In the old age, this is what tortures everyone. What I should not have done, oh God, why did I do that? What I should have done, oh God, why didn't I do that? And the shok, the regrets of the past, they kill a person while alive. See? This I learned from one person. He was having a doctorate in something. So when I came to know he was ill, I went to see him. I said, Akshab, kaisa hale, what's wrong? So he said, please sit down. And he told me, Swamiji, you call me by any name. You call me rascal, fool, anything you call. I will not get hurt. But if you call me doctor, I get hurt. I said, okay. Mahatmaji, how are you? He said, you didn't ask why I shouldn't call you doctor. I said, no, why? That is your personal thing. I don't want to know anything about anybody in this world. I'm very clear. He said, no. Then he started. I got my doctorate on this particular topic. My own student has proved what I have proved was wrong. And I have signed that thesis. And he is a doctorate now, working under me, and I am the one who got the doctorate on something wrong. And I am regretting what rubbish I did. See, friends, Shreyas is this. Mind is at peace. Bhagwan says, Dukheshu anudvigrimanaha, Sukheshu vigatispraha. In the third chapter, Bhagwan says, Nirmamo nirashi bhutva yudhyasva vigatajvara. The past and the future should not disturb us even one moment. Then the Shreyas, the ultimate good has happened to us. Shreyaha tadhi vijyaniyat yasmat bhuyo na shochati. And this is what Bhagavad says in Gita, God realization. Brahma bhuta prasannatma na shochati na kangshati. See, prasannatma, ever cheerful. And who is ever cheerful? He who is no more carrying the burden of the past or worries of the future. That is called as the real devotion. So Shreyas Tati Vijaniyad Yasman Bhuyono Shochati Shokaha Sarvata Evasya Drushati Sukshmaya Drusha. And if you see with a subtle understanding, with a Sukshma Drushti, you will see everywhere Sarvataha eva drishyate. Everywhere you see, the whole world is full of these regrets, frustration. Oh, this is that, that is this. No end to this. Yashokaihi anusambhinnam nasta shreyohi sarvata dhanam putra tatha dara rajyam klesho balam yashaha vidya buddhi darshanancha deha saundaryaspada sarvametan asthiratvat kala sarvamukastitam shokankura mahashakti bijatmikatayasitam kuta atyantika shreya sadhanatvam samarhati. Now he says that in this world, these wealth, the children, the wife, the kingdom, the money, the strength, the kirti or the glory in this world, wisdom, knowledge, intellect, beauty, health, everything is absolutely unsteady. As if they are already in the mouth of the snake of time, and therefore this shok is seated in these relations and in these possessions. So the cause of all the shok or misery is two things: relations and possessions. Relations make us somebody, and possessions makes us someone. We have to learn the art of living. L-E-A-V-I-N-G. See? Enough of holding God to this world. Drop everything. So, kutaha atyantika shreya sadhanatvam samarhati. Therefore, all these relations and possessions, how they can be the ultimate cause of fulfillment in life. Ataha paramakam shreya etadvai mukhyato bhaved evam dhanadi visaye yada deyatva vibhramaha. Therefore, one has to understand that whatever is the supreme cause of realization or fulfillment is the one which I am going to tell you. And what people think, dhanadi visaye, that wealth or relations and possession, this is the cause of fulfillment of happiness, then it is actually out of the delusion. And this moha deva samudbhuta mohako hi maheshwara yo hi sarva jagat karta tasva sarve hi mohita. And who is this one who is putting us into this moha or the delusion? Is the maheshwara, who is the creator of this world. And therefore the whole world is under the influence of this maheshwara in the delusion, and they are constantly suffering, and nobody can ever help them. Hereafter he tells one or two simple examples that kachi devam na sarvan yajaspat hi mataha alpavidyam mayinascha upakranta janayataha mahadeva mahamayam kaha sankrantam arati. Even the small magicians on the stage, they do some kind of magic because of which people get deluded. But this Maheshwara, who is the creator of this whole world, the great magician, before him nothing can stand. Therefore, if we want to get out of the magic tricks, we go and propitiate the magician, become his disciple, learn, pay him and do his seva. Then he will teach us the secrets of the magic. In the same manner, this great Mayavi, this Maheshwara, we have to serve him. We have to be devoted to him. We have to propitiate him. And therefore, unless you are devoted to the divine, your knowledge will never take place. See, devotion without question is the only way to get out of the web of logic. There has to be one altar in life. Maybe a person or a place or an object, anything, or a goal, wherein logic is totally cancelled. Then only we can go beyond logic. Because logic can be the most detrimental in one's life. Therefore, here, Mahamohasataranam tasma sarva tha ashrayed. Tasman mahamayinam tam aprasadya katham aved. Therefore, if you want to go out of the maya moha created by the great mayavi, the Lord Shiva, we must be devoted to him. Without that, this can never happen. Yastam prasade samyak prapyatasya prasadataha mahavidyam samahan tan mohan dhruvam utkrantim eshati. And therefore, one should propitiate the Lord through devotion, and by his prasada, by his blessing alone, one is able to attain the mahavidya, the ultimate knowledge, which will be able to destroy the delusion and the effects of the delusion, and one can transcend all of them. Annepi yoga kathita shriya sadhana karmani maheshwara prasadate vinanasyu pralaptahe. There are many paths which are told, but all of them will be successful only by devotion to the Maheshwara, the Lord. Tasmad aradhayet adau Mahesham Vishwakaranam Bhaktyasa sadhayet ashu yogan moha vinashanam. Therefore, when you start your spiritual practice, never begin it without devotion to the Lord. See, if you are regularly practicing, after you sit down, suppose you straighten your body, do some pranayama, etc., then chant Lord's name for 10-15 minutes, some stotras, some Gita chapter. By that, slowly the mind becomes oriented to something higher, what is called as God. And with that quality of the mind, and when you study, then it doesn't remain only as a logic and reason, but then it becomes understanding. No more knowledge. It becomes understanding. Knowledge need not be understood, but understanding is the one which ultimately matures into conviction. And unless there is conviction, we will never change ourselves. In this manner, tasman aradhayet ado mahesham vishvakaranam bhagdyasa sadhayet ashu yogan moha vinashanam. And because of his devotion to him, we will be able to go beyond this delusion because of which we are suffering. Now, after this, the next topic about devotion to the Lord is taken, which we'll take in our tomorrow's class. Om Purnamadaha Purnamidam Purnaat Purnamudachate Purnasya Purnamadaya Purnameva Vashishyate. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Hari Om. Sri Gurubhyo Namaha. Hari Om.